What's up, everyone? If you're watching this video, chances are you just bought a brand new complete bike and you're looking to build it up. Hopefully you bought it from Dan's Comp, but if not, I guess we'll still help you out, but you know, think better next time. Anyway, when you first get your complete bike, it will arrive in a big box just like this. Just like this. Like this. Like this. Just like this. Like this. First up, you'll want to remove the bike and all the packaging. This really is the most time-consuming part of the whole process, so let's speed this up a little. Okay, now that you've removed all the packaging, now's a good time to inspect the bike for any sort of damage. These bikes do come pretty well packaged from the manufacturer, but sometimes accidents can happen during shipping. If on the off chance you do notice anything, just give us a call and one of our customer service reps will get you taken care of. It's at this point you'll want to record the bike's serial number, typically found on the underside of the bottom bracket. Law enforcement will need this number to help identify your bike if it ever ends up lost or stolen. If you lose this number, don't panic. Dan's Comp records the serial number with each order. As you can see, the bike already comes about 80% assembled. So all you need to install is the front wheel, seat post, seat, handlebars, and pedals. Before your bike ships from Dan's Comp, a trained tech will go through and inspect each pre-installed part for proper torque and installation. This also includes greasing bolts and adjusting chain and brake tension where needed, something that cannot be said by other online shops. Final assembly is done with a few simple hand tools, such as a 6mm Allen wrench, a ratchet and socket set, a ratchet extension if you have pegs, a 15mm or adjustable open-end wrench, some assembly grease, which we've already done for you if you bought from Dan's Comp, and preferably someone off camera to throw you tools. Well, I'm actually gonna need you to build this one too.
What the heck?
Dude, somebody's gotta narrate. First up is installing the seat and seat post. This bike comes with a one-piece seat post combo. So all you need to do is slide the seat post in and tighten down the clamp with your 6mm Allen wrench. And as I mentioned, all bolts will have grease or even Loctite in some situations if you ordered from Dan's. Did I mention we do all this for you? If you need help installing a railed or pivotal seat, check out our seat tech video linked above and in the description for more info. Next, using your 6mm Allen wrench, remove all stem bolts and insert the handlebars. Reinstall the stem clamp and snug up the bolts in an X pattern. Don't apply full torque just yet, as we'll be coming back to this later. Now flip the bike over to install the front wheel. Using your ratchet and socket, torque down the front axle nuts by alternating side to side for equal tension. If using pegs, insert the axle nut and washer inside the peg for proper installation. Your pedals can be found in the included parts box. This box will also include your pegs if included, and any other extra parts. Identify both the right and left pedal by looking for the R or L located typically on the pedal spindle or even the pedal body. Install the right side pedal by turning the threads clockwise. Start by hand to avoid cross-threading, then use your 15mm wrench for final torque. The left pedal is reverse thread and will need to be installed counterclockwise. Now let's flip the bike over and tighten the headset if needed. If you bought from Dan's Comp, we've already done this for you, but if not, you'll need to loosen the pinch bolts one at a time. From there, slowly tighten the compression bolt to remove any play from the headset, while still allowing the bars to move freely. Once completed, torque down the pinch bolts, alternating from side to side. For more information on this process, check out our headset video in the description below. Now let's go back to the handlebars and make some final adjustments. Loosen the stem bolts to move the bars to your preferred position. Then again, tighten the stem bolts in an X pattern, this time applying full and proper torque. Now is also the perfect time to make final adjustments to your seat height, check tires for proper air pressure, and if you have brakes, you can fine-tune the brake pool by using the barrel adjusters on your lever and frame.
And that, my friends,
is it. Of course, if you have any questions, let us know in the comment section down below, or you can always call us, email us, or even online chat to speak with a bike tech.
Operators are standing by.
And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. With that, are you ready to ride?
Dude, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Yeah, I did too.
Okay, perfect.
Oh, I'm pretty sure that hammer got my toe.